Big Ron Atkinson was in the dugout for this 1981 match with Wolves. It turned out to be a very one-sided affair. Commentary comes from Martin Tyler.
United still with Ashranks waiting for the cross. And Bertels puts it into the side netting. Giving United strikers space for headers, and it was Bertels this time who couldn't hit the target. Wilkins, good vision to pick out McElroy. And here's Stapleton in a race with Bradshaw. And Frank Stapleton puts Manchester United in front in the ninth minute. In a move that owed a great deal to Ray Wilkins. McElroy's pass sending Stapleton on his way for the scoring touch, but beyond that, Wilkins had swept an instant ball forward that was at the real hub of the move. Wilkins making the forward run. Popple collecting the header as it dropped from Parkin. Gallagher's miss kick, and it almost let in Stapleton. Gallagher acknowledging his mistake. Thanking Palmer for his efforts. A real air shot coming up here from Gallagher. And Stapleton was on target until it struck Palmer. Parkin clearing at the near post for Wolves. Kane McElroy perhaps thinking this time of the shot, which was covered by Parkin. Bertels allowed to turn. Getting in the way of Wilkins' attempt to thread it back to Bertels. And then presented here for McElroy again, who makes the most of it. Well, a catastrophic error from Peter Daniel, I think it was, who gave it straight to McElroy, who punished the error with his left foot. Here's Koppel on a run. Now Orbiston and Bertels in acres of space. Koppel and Palmer almost turning it back into Koppel's stride. And a move fully deserving of the applause. And Wolves on the rack at the moment. McElroy gets it back from Stapleton. Here's Bertels. And again, as an end product of the build-up. Bertels swivelling into the shot on his stronger left foot. And Sammy McElroy, at the moment, Wolves finding it impossible to contain him. Goodman. And McElroy. Fine work from Bradshaw. Sammy McElroy performing today in front of the Northern Ireland team manager Billy Bingham, who must be delighted in what he's seeing. And McElroy so close to getting his second goal there, and good reflexes from Bradshaw. Here's Wilkins. And the uncertainty from Palmer this time. And he was trying to give a corner and didn't even accomplish that. This is Wilkins. And it's swerved away from Berry. And it's Moses with a deflection, and the overhead kick came from Stapleton. And Bradshaw, who was twisting this way and that, finally gratefully clasping the ball. The save, simple enough when it came after the ball went around the penalty area like a pin table. And Bradshaw scrambling to his feet to deal with the effort from Stapleton. Wolves really finding it difficult to make any sort of meaningful progress. Stapleton, and it dipped against the bar. Wilkins was in rebound. Augustin. The pressure's still on. Until Hibbett gets a foot in to buy Wolves some time. But Wolves still wondering about the let-off from Stapleton. The dipping effort that struck the bar. Wilkins has made a break forward. Here's Stapleton, now McElroy. Really is fine football from Manchester United. With Bertels able to finish another move of the highest quality. With two players, Ray Wilkins here and Sammy McElroy involved. Two players whose future at Old Trafford has been open to some question, but contributing to the build-up that ended with Bertel slicing the shot. Ron Atkinson must be highly pleased with the first half performance from Manchester United, but will surely be expecting them to continue in the same vein in the second half. And that's Bertels linking up again with Stapleton in a manner that will gladden Ron Atkinson's heart. And Koppel adjudged offside. Well, the linesman was flagging, and it may be that Mr. Bridges has overruled him. The flag stays up. Berry, who's already been spoken to strongly in the first half, played on and brought Koppel down outside the area. Still, the linesman on the near side has his flag up. And Mr. Bridges, who is a referee who always enjoys playing the advantage, has not waved the flag away, so one must assume he hasn't seen it. Andy Gray has now gone over to make that point. And the referee shows that he is in charge. And the free kick will be taken by McElroy, who scores, and that will lead surely to protests from Wolves. Mr. Bridges has sprinted away. This was McElroy's effort that curved spectacularly past Bradshaw. Andy Gray leading the protests. Flag went up immediately. The initial ball was played through for Steve Koppel, who was then brought down. McElroy shows the delight of getting his second goal and of bringing Manchester United 3 for the first time here at Old Trafford since they drew 3-3 with Aston Villa on October the 8th last year. Bertels couldn't keep it in. Little's just getting enough on the ball to help it on to Stapleton. Moses picking out Koppel. It was an awkward run to control, but he accomplished it well. Bertels flick, and Stapleton blocked by Palmer. And it's Moses, blocked by Berry. Well, Wolves hanging on a thread from going 4 goals behind. Koppel dinking it in. Another area of confusion, letting in Stapleton for the first shot. Then it was Moses who found Berry in the way. It's put behind by Moses. As Gray caused some confusion beyond the far post. Matthews will take the corner for Wolves. And Bailey, as Gallagher puts it in, Bailey was fouled by Gray, which was the reason that the ball went as far beyond Andy Gray to Joe Gallagher. A push here by Gray as he jumps. Gallagher finished it off, but it didn't count. Wilkins linking up with McElroy again. Can Birtles keep it going? He can. Not quite into the path of McElroy. A move that brings just a small smile of contentment from Ron Atkinson, with Brian Robson, of course, alongside him. Always a man available for Manchester United. It's Coppell this time. Alderson is forward inside of him. Here's Wilkins. Now Alderson. McElroy, who's at the moment just content to sit back and wait for the next thrust, which McElroy might provide here. Birtle's going in. Buchan coming through the back of Gray. Getting the ball cleanly. Alderson. Birtles. The touch was short. So much of Manchester United's work has been this afternoon. And Sammy McElroy produces a hat-trick in superb style. Would have been hard really to produce something to top his work in this game, but he's managed it. A swerver that had Paul Bradshaw totally perplexed. McElroy wasting no chance and really belting it past Bradshaw. Matthews. Here's Daniel. And that was Hibbett. Stapleton. And Birtles. Magnificent goal. Well, you won't see two strikers link up as well as that, surely all season. The Frank Stapleton, Gary Birtles partnerships very much in business. And Stapleton just toe-ending it through. Bailey missed it, Birtles didn't. This is Coppell. McElroy. Moses. Now Coppell. And Birtles denied a second. And applauds the save from Bradshaw. Just the thinnest of touches from Coppell's cross, and the beleaguered Bradshaw hangs on. Gray, who's kept working in the Wolves cause, the losing cause it's been for so long, really from the ninth minute when Stapleton set United on their way. And Gray nearly making contact until Bailey snaked up the left arm. Well, they came here to welcome the new recruit, Brian Robson, but they go away celebrating the work of a long-time hero, Sammy McElroy, who walks off the field, a player not renowned for scoring goals, but a hat-trick to his name today. The others from Frank Stapleton and Gary Birtles, which leaves us with the question now of just who does Ron Atkinson leave out to make way for Robson?